news. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
Late Show avec Craig Ferguson in Paris, sponsored by Straight Talk. Cut your cell phone bill in half and feel richer.
It's hard to stay up, it's been a long, long day. And you got the Sandman at your door. But hang on, leave the TV on, and let's do it anyway. It's okay, you can always sleep through work tomorrow, okay? Hey, hey, tomorrow's just your future, yesterday.
Merci.
It's okay, baby, you can do it in Paris.
Thanks a lot, everybody. Thanks a lot, completely fake audience that isn't really there, just like when we do the show in California. Welcome to the Champ de Mars. Welcome to Paris, France. I am your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. It's a great day for America, everybody. It's a great day for us because we made it here to Paris with the tiny amount of money we had. We spent it on some coach airfares and one croissant, but we made it. We don't have a studio, we don't have any lighting, but that never stopped us in America, and it's not going to stop us here. We're going to have this thing ready in double quick European comedy time.
Let's take a short break and enjoy some Michael Caine in space in Paris.
Whenever I meet a French girl, I kiss her on both cheeks. Then I stand up and say hello. See what I did?
The whole, that's the good stuff. And now we return you to our regularly scheduled program. Get busy watching or get busy sleeping.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the show here in Paris, France, for the week. Our first guest this week, we're very lucky to have her. She's one of the most beautiful and talented French actresses working today. She is incandescent. She is everything that people think about in Paris. Please welcome the very beautiful and talented Kristen Bell, everybody. Kristen Bell. Kristen, you look very French.
Thank you.
It's very nice to see you. Look, there you are. I got your coffee
there with this thing.
And we got our stuff. It's fantastic. Are you having a nice time in Paris? I didn't know you lived here.
I don't. But what a scene,
it's nice. Yeah, it's very nice.
I always thought you should come to Paris and do a show.
Yeah, well, I'm very glad that I came. Do you spend a lot of time here? Have you been here before?
I don't. I've never been here, no, but I've been thinking about...
Kristen Bell. I can't stand her. You know what you look like to me, Kristen Bell, with your French hat and your cheap shoes. You look like a rube, a well-scrubbed, hustling rube with little taste.
There, people are walking their dogs here.
Yeah, and it's an off-leash park.
There's a nice dog. Show that dog over, see if he'll come over. See if he'll come over to you.
Puppy!
Can we see your dog?
He's camera shy.
Yeah, he just wants to be on a better show. Hello.
Hello.
It's very nice to see you, dog. We have to take a break. We'll be right back we're in Paris with Kristen Bell and the lovely dog and Jeff Peterson and the back leg Denim boys.
The dog just pee on me. Do it again.
On the bus.
What are you staring at, Belle?
Why are you two so tense all the time?
He starts
it! Listen, I'll stop it. I'll take it. Everybody will go home right now. I'll take us home right now. Right now! Don't make me come back there!
I need to go to the bathroom.
You can't go to the bathroom. Actually, you can actually go to the bathroom.
I'm programmed to have to pee.
No, you're not. You're lying to me. You don't even have any liquid. I know he's touching you. He's trying to make friends. Look, come on.
I extend my bony hand as a sign of peace.
Look, see? Come on. There. Isn't that nice?
Touch it. Touch the hand.
You hear that, Bill? It's that time again. Time for emails. Let's do it.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the show. Do applause like it's in the studio. Welcome back to the show, everybody. It's time to do the email segment. Do you want to do an email? This is my friend Sylvie's going to help me with the emails, all right?
Hi.
Are you familiar with what we do?
No, not at
all. All right, what we do is we accept emails from all over the United States and the rest of the world, and then we help people.
Anonymous.
No, they're not anonymous.
Oh, Joan, okay.
That's from Joan. Well, this is from Joan in, well, read that out. Joan in...
Olathe
in Kansas.
Okay.
All right, and Joan says, hi, Craig and Sylvie and Jeff. Have you met Jeff?
I don't want to meet Jeff.
Hey.
I'm trying to avoid him.
Wait, what the hell? That's rude.
So rude.
That was rude.
Man.
You're being rude. He's very sensitive.
He's quite intimidating.
Well, you mustn't let him intimidate you. He's actually adorable, aren't you?
I am.
See? All right.
Okay, we'll catch up.
He says, hi, Craig and Sylvie and Jeff. I've been dating a guy for about a month, and he's a genuinely good guy, but he has significant body odor. Do I break it off, or do I tell him that he stinks?
Break it off? Yeah.
Wait a minute, so you live and work in France, but yet you wouldn't date someone who has body odor?
Absolutely not.
You're in the wrong damn town. All right, this is from Emmanuel in Lyon in France.
Hey, whoa, okay.
All right then, you ready? Hi, Craig and Sophie. New York City has the bagel, but we have the croissant. If you had to pick one, which would you choose? Bagel or croissant?
Bagel croissant.
Bagel croissant?
Yeah, a mix of the two. Half-half.
You can get that?
I think we should make it.
Are you suggesting we get into business together?
Yeah.
With a bagel croissant?
Absolutely.
We have to give it a name that combines the word bagel and croissant, though. You can't say a bagel croissant. Jeff?
Baguette.
No. Baguette doesn't make sense. They already have baguette.
Baguette.
All right. I don't think baguette works.
I think he should be in the business with us.
Oh, really?
No.
I think he would be a very good mascot. I think people would love to see you.
Hi, come down and try our bagel croissant.
See? I think that'd be awesome. All right.
All right, next
one. All right, this is... I'm sorry for listening. We'll pick these up later. Or we'll get the horse to do it. Have you met
Let's get the horse. Let's get
All right,
the
horse then. Okay. Who's that at the door? Oh, it's Secretariat. Oh, the music doesn't stop. What? Oh, there you go. There, oh, the music started. You have to get up. Do you want a drink of water? Oh, look, she's sniffing. She's sniffing Moose's big furry probe thing.
I want to.
What? You want to what? You want to sniff Moose's probe?
Yes.
No, you can't. Not right now. This is from Wendy in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Have you ever been to Santa Fe, New Mexico?
Never.
Have you ever been to America?
Yeah, New York.
New York, yes.
San Francisco.
Yes, you've been to San Francisco.
Oh, I got a place there.
He's got a little place there.
Yeah,
what
you should
do
come
in your
by.
Little place? Yeah, you should go by.
Oh, it's really fun. I like to throw
awkward
beans.
Moment.
Oh, you, no, I didn't ask you, and it's not awkward moment. It's awkward pause, and you've got to wait until I ask you for it.
Okay.
She's pushy, isn't
she? It's unbelievable.
Unbelievable. She was rude to you. She was pushy to me. She brings her dog on, and then she said we didn't rehearse the dance with Secretariat like we rehearsed.
Are you kidding me?
I know. It's like working with Barbara Streisand.
Oh.
That would be a dream, though, wouldn't it?
Oh.
Yeah. I know. All right. This is.
Okay, I'll try.
All right. Wendy in Santa Fe, New Mexico says, Craig. Our baby daughter is teething and won't stop crying. Is it true a little liquor will ease the pain for us both?
Yes.
Giving a baby alcohol?
Absolutely.
That's one over there right now.
Yeah.
No, you mustn't ever give a baby alcohol. CBS cares, right, Jeff?
CBS cares.
CBS cares.
Okay.
All right. This is from Claude in Bruges.
Oh, my God, okay. Yes.
You know Claude?
Oh, I do.
You do know Claude?
Yeah,
let me ask you a question. Does Claude in Bruges, does he wear...
He's very famous.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, thanks. Thanks, Colette. You reminded me I'm a man. All right.
How do I convince my wife that sex in a public place is a good idea?
Would you ever do that? Go
never,
on, you would. It's all right, you can tell me. Would you ever do that?
Never. But I have witnessed some customers at the bookshop doing.
Have people had sex in there? Really?
I mean, I probably shouldn't be telling you.
No, you shouldn't,
but
just tell me.
The liquor that you just gave me. No, well, you know, I've heard stories. I maybe haven't caught them firsthand.
No, you've seen it. You've seen it.
Don't give Jeff any ideas.
Would you have sex in a public place?
Quoth the raven, balls.
Yeah, very literary,
yes,
Jeff.
Yes.
Thanks very much. That's really impressive. This is from Monroe in France. How do you say that? Saint-Noir in France. Says, Craig, if you could take one thing from France back to the US, what would it be?
Thank you.
Would you like to come back to America?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah. All right, one more and then we gotta go. This is from Jean in Marseille in France. He says, Bonjour, Craig. If you could meet one famous French historical figure, who would it be? Oh, well, you first. Who would it be?
No, this is... You have to...
Well, I have to say, I think for me...
I think you're going to say Napoleon.
No, not at all. I'm not at all interested in meeting a politician. No, I think actually maybe Victor Hugo.
Mm. Yeah. Well, Notre Dame.
Yeah, exactly. And he had
a hunchback of Notre
fabulous
Dame.
Beard. And he had two families, Victor Hugo. Did you know that?
Yes.
He was a bit of a rascal. Did you know that about Victor Hugo?
I did.
Yeah, hunchback of Notre Dame family and the Les Miserables family.
The what?
Yeah, that
family. The what?
Never mind. We're out of time. So we have to choose awkward pause or mouth organ?
Mouth organ.
You want a mouth organ?
That sounds good, yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah. Well, there's yours.
I can't. I really can't play.
Well, that's all right. Neither can anyone else. It's fine. You're amongst friends.
Oh,
take the organ out and give it a blow.
And what about Jeff?
Go on.
And Jeff? No?
Jeff will play as well. Watch it. Right. We'll do 1, 2, 3. It'll be me. Wait.
Okay.
God. Like you, then me, then Jeff. Are you ready?
Okay,
right.
Ready.
All right, go. Everybody, we'll be right back. It's Gay Perry.
Si votre vie vous laisse avec les questions, cherchez les conseils de la mer. Cher homme, à quoi, cher homme, à quoi, donnez-moi votre conseil, s'il vous plaît, homme, à quoi.
Bonsoir, mes amis. It is I, l'homme d'Aqua. Letter, please. Merci, Michel. You're a real Cap de Triomphe. Dear Aquaman, how do you know when you are really in love? Well, your heartbeat escalates, your palms start to sweat, you feel all woozy. Oh, that's also when shrooms kick in. What was the question again? My hands have turned into candy.
Donnez-moi votre conseil, s'il vous plaît, homme à toi.
Look at that. Oh, the Eiffel Tower is named after the guy who designed it, Bruce Tower. No, Gustave Eiffel. He only had the permit to keep it up for 20 years, but the French let it stay, and now it'll be here forever, like Jay Leno on The Tonight Show. Now, the main reason the Eiffel Tower was allowed to stay up is that somebody realized it's a great place to put radio towers, and that's what it's used for today, radio. So all of France gets crystal clear radio reception to hear great French rock bands like...
A la vie, à l'amour, à nos nuits, à nos jours.
The tower's nickname is La Dame de Fer, which is the Iron Lady. Coincidentally, also the nickname of former UK Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher.
To those waiting with bated breath.
They called her the Iron Lady too. But the Eiffel Tower and Margaret Thatcher, very different of course. One's had thousands of men climbing all over it since the 1800s, and the other one is the Eiffel Tower. In 2008, there was an American woman who was obsessed with the Eiffel Tower. She came here to marry the tower, which is ridiculous. You can't go around marrying inanimate objects, but if you can, I'll take Big Ben. And I don't mean the clock. I said clock. Come in.
You know that the tower just stand up. She's not fixed on the ground.
What, it moves around?
Yeah, she's shaking, she sways all day long due to the wind, but just a little, and due to the sun.
The sun? Or the expansion of the metal. The metal will expand and contract.
Yes. If you see at the end of the jack, there is a trolley moving with a wheel. Now you have green engine.
A hydraulic engine right there on it. That's a very long shaft you have here.
It's 12 meters long.
Whoa, here it comes, here it comes, here it comes.
Yeah.
Look, 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 look. It's pretty cool,
I never thought I was afraid of heights, but right now as this elevator is climbing up and I'm talking to you, I just pooed my pants.
Oh, are you gonna vomit?
It's a little unnerving, actually, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you want to hold on to anything for safety?
Good idea.
After you.
I'll see. This is so exciting.
It's very nice, isn't it?
I feel elegant when I'm here.
You look elegant.
Thank you, Craig.
Want to spit? Yeah. All right, spit. Whoa. All right, here's one.
Make it a good one.
No, I'm not doing it. I don't actually spit. I had my spit glands removed during the war.
Look at these little apartments right here.
No, they're just regular size apartments. We're just far away from
them. But they're so small.
No, see these people over there that are playing soccer? They're actually regular size people. It's just we are very far away. You would think that we were about 20 foot up and they were midgets. But we're actually much further up, and they're regular-sized people.
I'm not buying it.
It's the trick of perspective. You can't get that many midgets in a soccer team. I've tried. Do you see? I think, take a look. We'll be right back.
horse gets everywhere.
That horse gets around.
It's beautiful, isn't it? It's one of the most romantic spots on earth, you know this. Beautiful. You know, it's kind of interesting because, you know, we're here and, you know, my wife isn't here and Dax is not here, and but we are, you know, in this romantic. Do my ass too.
Welcome back, everybody. At this point, you're probably asking yourself, how did a crappy low-budget show like this end up in Paris? Well, that's easy. Through discount travel and the narrowly averted international incident.
Someone tweeted me on the Twitter that a clip of this show that they saw in France. It's a French talk show. And so I looked at it and I'm like, don't steal from this show. That's like taking pants from a hobo.
I'm doing the show.
No, you're doing my show. You're copying me.
No, ridiculous. Oh, I've got a present for you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is it Marie?
No. This is...
Wow!
This is so...
Thank you so much.
You charming bastard. You just charmed me. I'm not even gay and I'd do you. I would like to invite you to a show in France.
Do you know what you're gonna say in French?
Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna say when I do it in America.
This could be the start of a beautiful friendship.
Welcome back to the show, everybody. My guest at the moment is my friend Arthur. Jacques, why are you called Arthur or Jacques?
Because when I started my career on a radio station, there were already a guy named Jacques. So they said you have to choose another name. And in France, every year, we're choosing a name for dogs.
Really?
A, B, C, D. It was the name of A. They say, oh, choose a name with A, so I say Arthur.
Did you? Hey,
Are you famous in France?
No, I think you're famous in France. We're getting onto the auto route now.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's nice.
We are 10 minutes from Paris and you can see the Eiffel Tower. Yeah.
So, listen, you were on my show in America.
Yeah.
And I did your show here.
Yeah.
I hate you.
No, I trust you. Trust me.
No,
oh,
you,
no.
You bitch, you're trying
forgive
to destroy
me. Forgive me.
Oh, are you as turned on as I am?
Do you think there's a huge difference between what we do?
I think it's exactly the same thing.
Yeah, but for legal reasons, not exactly the same thing.
Sorry?
For legal reasons, not exactly the same. Hey, you're allowed to cuss on your show. You can actually say cuss words on your show?
Yeah, everyone's.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, there are no words that you can't say?
No, the only words we can say are Facebook or Twitter.
Why can't you say Facebook and Twitter?
I don't know. They decide the French FCC told us you can't say Facebook and Twitter.
We can say
croissant as much as we want, but we can say Twitter.
You can say what as much as you want?
Zut alors.
Oh, how charmingly French of
yeah,
you.
Yeah, with my sexy accent.
Yeah. You know? Whenever you go into a tunnel, do you ever get scared?
It depends.
I'm a bit scared in here.
Yeah.
Have you ever been in the tunnel? There's a tunnel called the Holland Tunnel in New York. It's a little scary.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
It's like, I keep thinking that, like, the water's gonna come in over the top of me. This is one of the most beautiful tunnels of France.
We're very proud of that tunnel.
This is the nicest tunnel. Americans, people come from all over the world to see this tunnel.
Yeah.
Is the tunnel in your book? She's pretty high right now.
So no.
Oh, look, and look, there's the Eiffel Tower now. That is very nice.
Porte de Saint-Cloud.
Porte de Saint-Cloud?
De Saint-Cloud.
Right?
This is the end of the
tunnel.
The tunnel. Yeah. And the beginning of Paris.
Ah, this is the beginning of Paris.
Yes.
Oh, this is great. Another tunnel.
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Famous, you know.
All right. This is one of
Saint-Cloud Tunnel.
Saint-Cloud Tunnel?
Yeah.
The tunnels of Paris.
Yeah.
Now, this tunnel is a little bit different than the other tunnel.
It's shorter.
It's shorter, but it's louder.
Louder, yeah.
Ah, oh, there you are. You see the end of the tunnel. That's two tunnels we did.
Yeah, I see.
Do you ever go to the, you know, the fun fair?
Yeah.
And you go into the Tunnel of Love? You know what the Tunnel of Love is?
Yeah.
You ever go in there with girls, do your French accent too?
Yes. I love the Tunnel of Love, but in France, it doesn't mean the same thing. Be careful.
Oh, really?
If you try to translate the Tunnel of Love, it's a tunnel of love, but doesn't mean the same thing.
What does it? Does it mean? Is it something to do on somebody's?
Oh, you've got two Tunnel of Love.
All right, I get it. Yeah, no, you're all right. You're all right. We'll be right back after these messages.
And now it's time for Sean Connery's Parisian Memories.
My favorite trip to Paris was the time I went drunk bungee jumping off the Eiffel Tower. Well, not so much jumping as falling 1,000 feet. I survived by landing on a mime. So in a way, you could say it was a public service.
That was Sean Connery's Parisian Memories. I love that guy. And now, Kristen and Craig enjoy dinner with a French movie star.
You two worked together before, didn't you?
We did.
What did you do? Movie.
We did Couples Retreat in Bora Bora.
Oh, yeah.
And Jean and his diving instructor from the Big Blue took us down to swim and with lemon sharks and reef sharks, and it was amazing.
Did you, with
John Favreau, Vince Vaughn?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I went to Bora Bora and I had a phone call from a guy who was the chief diver from the Big Blue.
That's amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And he was living there and he had a club, kind of a club to dive for the tourists. And I said to him, can we have a boat? And then I'll ask the actors and actresses to come, and then we go with the sharks. But I didn't say to them.
You didn't tell them you were going with the sharks?
No.
That would piss me off a little bit if I was down there.
Oh, I loved it.
Oh, really?
I have no fear when it comes. I've never been attacked by anything, so I don't consider it a possibility. Kind of like fires. In Los Angeles, I would watch the fires in Los Angeles from the balcony at the house, and I would just say, this is not real, it doesn't actually exist, because I've never experienced it.
That's an absurd way.
I know, but I don't know how to have a fear about it. But the sharks were down there, and it was wonderful. I mean, they were as close as you and I.
I know, I did the shark diving in the Bahamas.
Did you love it?
Yeah, I did like it. I was amazed. Did you know this about sharks, that in many species of shark, the male of the species has two penises?
Two? You really?
Two penises. Is it penises or peni?
Peni.
I've never used the plural.
No, of course.
But I, in sharks, they have two penises in
What's
case.
What's the purpose?
Well,
in case what?
In case they want to have some kind of sex party or something. I don't know. Though they have two. There's obviously an evolutionary reason for it. They, I guess. In case one fails,
and you for the teeth, no, the tooth they have.
The teeth go quickly.
Three ranks, no. Mm-hmm.
So there
are few animals that they have. They change the teeth all their life, mm-hmm. And the sharks they change their teeth. When they lose one teeth, another one comes.
Yes, didn't you get a shark tooth when you were there?
I did. I went shark tagging about a month and a half ago, and we pulled up a big tiger shark onto the boat, and I mean it was like 8.5 feet long, and you have to sit on her and you have to do it all in under 3 minutes.
How did you know it was a her? Because it was
they said
it's a fantastic animal.
Yeah, well, one of the greatest naturalists or greatest underwater explorers ever was of course a Frenchman, Jacques Cousteau, who used to come to this restaurant
with the red hat.
He used to always wear a red hat. I used to watch the shows when I was a kid, and he would always, no matter where they went in the world, they'd be on the Calypso, was the boat.
Yes.
And Jacques Cousteau, the crew would always make friends with a local otter. Even if there weren't otters around, if they were in a place where there were no otters, they would say, the crew have befriended an otter.
Otters are so cute, but I heard they're kind of mean, like ostriches. Aren't they kind of nasty?
Are ostriches nasty? I didn't
ostriches.
Know that ostriches were nasty.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have you ever met a nice ostrich?
I've never met any ostriches at all, actually. I don't know anything about ostriches.
I think they're nasty.
They're like feathery land sharks?
I don't want to gossip, but I've heard that they're nasty.
Are you very fascinated by the natural world, then? Do you go diving here?
I'm passionate by the sea, because the sea for me is liberty. The sea is my soul. The sea is the soul of humanity. When you look at the sea, it gives you a sentiment, I mean, an impression of big, you know. It's I can do anything. And at the same time, I can return to my mother. I can return to my past. I don't know. The movement of the sea, the sound, the smell, everything from the sea is fantastic for me.
Wow.
It is true, because I was born in Casablanca, so in front of the ocean. So when you go in front of the ocean, it's like, oh, my goodness, I'm so little.
You're from there originally?
Yeah, I was born in Casablanca.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Quite a lot of Frenchmen I've met on this trip are from Morocco. A lot of people come up from Morocco.
From Africa, yes. My father and my mother were from south of Spain.
Yeah.
Andalusian.
Yeah.
You know, the flamenco.
Yeah, and where they make the very big bullfighting bulls in Andalusia.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then they moved because of the poverty and because of the war. They were Republican. And at that time, you had a dictator called Franco.
Franco,
voila. He moved from south of Spain to Morocco, and then I was born there, and my sister also.
Have you ever been to Morocco?
Mm-mm.
I've been to Morocco, it's awesome.
I want to go. Yeah, no,
it's very nice, very sweet country.
Yeah.
Very sweet people. Very sweet.
A huge French. Most people speak French there, actually.
Completely.
Right? Yeah.
Completely. And they had two, when I was born, they had two American bases there. Just after the Second World War, you had two big American bases there.
In Morocco?
In Morocco, yes.
Is that where you learned to speak English then, from the Americans there?
No, I learned to speak English for the Big Blue, because the Big Blue was shot in English.
Yeah.
So they said to me, you have to speak English, and you have to make people to understand you.
Wow.
Otherwise...
Otherwise, you don't get the job.
We're going to doubt you, huh? We're going to loop you.
Yeah, like they do for me on the show.
Wow.
They do.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
That was frightening.
You did it, though. You're good at it.
Thank you.
Yeah. We have to take a break. We'll be right back to the Late Late Show à Paris.
Late Late Show.
You're real French. You're a frog.
Watch this. I've been practicing my shrug. Watch this. You ready?
Quoi?
Quoi? There's a few things I got to take care of before we all get to bed. So, come on, little fella. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's tip you down here. See if we can get you to drink, all right? You having a nice time?
Good.
Good. Just nod. Nod is fine. Want to do a little dance? All right. You called? Here, I'll put this on your shoulder. Is that nice?
Sacré bleu!
You know, it all seems like a dream now, Paris, doesn't it?
It really does.
Yeah, Craig. Yeah. What was your favorite part of the show that we've just done? Because, you know, the whole thing about going to Paris is that we have to do the whole show there, then we come back here for the end of the show, and we have to go back to Paris tomorrow to do another show. All this traveling's getting the better of me. It's all right for you. You just unplug yourself and put yourself in a suitcase. But I've got to sit coach next to the bathroom all the way to Paris. And some of these people traveling to Paris are from France and they go to the bathroom.
Man, did you have a bad croissant this morning?
All right, what did you like the most about Paris, then?
Well, I particularly enjoyed the bookstore.
I liked the bookstore, too. I was surprised that you liked it, though, because there were no outlets in which you could actually plug yourself into in there.
You make a good point.
Yeah. Did you like it because there were the types of books you like to read in that bookstore in Paris?
Yes.
Really? And what books do you like to read, Jeff?
Classic books like the Iliad.
Oh, you you like to read the Iliad?
Sure.
Sure. Tell me what the Iliad's about then, Jeff.
Well, there's this Iliad thing, and these guys have to go on a long trip and find it, and oh, man, it's great.
Wait. That's Ocean's 11 you're talking about.
You bested me, Ferguson. No. I enjoyed the bookstore. I enjoyed the people there.
That lady was very attractive, wasn't she?
She was smoking hot.
I mean, and that's coming from you, a gay robot.
Mama.
Yeah. She's a very attractive woman. I think she kind of liked me.
I think she did too, Craig. Well, you're a very learned gentleman, and she too is a very learned lady.
Well, you know what's interesting? I think she liked me when she saw that I was reading the Iliad.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah, that's right. I know how to attract the clever ladies. Read clever books in front of them. That's why you should always take your power book to Starbucks and pretend you're writing a script. Women are often fooled by such behavior. Or maybe they're not.
Sometimes you make a lot of sense.
Well, sometimes you make a lot of sense. Did you learn to speak any French when you were there?
A little, yeah.
Okay, let's hear it then.
Oui.
That's spectacular.
Oh, I get another one.
Well, we better get going. We have to get back to France for tomorrow night's big French show.
Baguette.
Au revoir. We'll see you tomorrow night. We'll see you tomorrow night, everybody.